Hello friends, Mandar here. I'm back with another video. Today we are going to look at the September 2021 visa bulletin that just came out today morning. Somebody as usual reminded me that the bulletin is out, so I thought I would make a video out of it. So we are going to closely look at the dates for family based category and employment based category, and I'm going to leave the timeline so that you can slide through the slider to whichever section you are interested in. So if you are interested in this topic, watch this video until the end and let's get started. If you are here for the first time, welcome. My name is Mandar and I make immigration related videos for US and Canada. I'm not an immigration lawyer, so anything that I say on this video or on my channel is for information purpose only. And for your specific immigration needs, you should hire a competent immigration lawyer. So visa bulletin comes every month around the mid of the month. So we have seen it come as early as 8th of the month, and we have seen it come as late as 25th of the month. But this month it is come in on 13th of the month. Also would like to point out that for this month until the end of the month, which is August 31st, you are still looking at August visa bulletin, because the September visa bulletin will only take into effect on 1st of September and onwards. But you can be prepared if your dates have become current as per the final action date chart. You can start preparing for your documentation for 485, and you can submit it as soon as 1st of September. So with that said, let's look at the comparative analysis of the visa bulletin. As usual, we'll do a side-by-side comparison of the previous month's visa bulletin, which is August visa bulletin, against September visa bulletin. Okay, so here we have visa bulletin for August on the left-hand side and visa bulletin for the September 2021 on the right-hand side. We'll go through the family-sponsored visa category first. So let me scroll down to that section. And there are four categories, actually five categories, as you can see: F1, F2A, F2B, F3 and F4. And so we'll first look at the final action dates chart for family based category. Now let's go to the first column on the left, which is F1. The dates for all chargeability have progressed by about a month. So basically 22nd of November 2014 to 1st of December 2014. So it's not even a month, it's actually a week. Pardon me. For China, they have progressed from November 22nd to December 1st, 22nd. Again, about a week. For India, also they have progressed from November 22nd to December 1st, again for a week. So all chargeability, China and India, all the same progression, only by a week or so. Mexico, it has progressed by 15 days, by about 2 weeks, from 1st of January 1999 to 15th of January 99. And for Philippines, it has not changed at all. For F2A category, all the codes remain the same, so all the dates are current for anybody. So if you are an F2A category, and F2A category, let's look at what it is. F2A category is spouses and children of permanent residents. So 77% of overall second preference limitation, of which 75% are exempt from the per country limit. So F2A category is all current. F2B category, all chargeability still remains the same at 22nd September 2015, same for China and same for India, nothing has changed. For Mexico, however, it has progressed by 2 weeks, from 1st of March 2000 to 15th of March 2000. And for Philippines, it has not progressed at all. So that is consistent with what Charlie has told us in the past, that except for Mexico and Philippines, we might not see much progression in this chart. For F3 category, all chargeability has progressed by about 2 weeks, from 8th of November to 22nd of November. And same for China and India. Seems like all chargeability, India and China, are moving in lockstep for F1, F2A, F2B and F3 categories. For Mexico, for F3, we are seeing the progression of almost 3 weeks, from 22nd of April to 15th of May of 1997. So they are still long backlogged and they are not progressing much, but there is slight progression. For Philippines, there is no change at all. For F4 category, there is a change of 3 weeks for all chargeability, from 1st of March 2007 to 22nd of March 2007, and the same for China as well, from 1st of March 2007 to 22nd of March 2007. For India, it has changed by 2 weeks, actually progressed by 2 weeks. So from 1st of September 2005 to 15th of September 2005. For Mexico, it has progressed by about 2 weeks, 22nd of January 99 to 8th of February 99. And for Philippines, it has changed by about 2 weeks, from 8th of August 2002 to 22nd of August 2002. So all in all, as you can see, there is a consistent progression for all chargeability, China and India, whereas from Mexico and Philippines, there is the slightly different progression. So that is consistent with what we heard from Charlie. Even though this final action date chart has progressed, Charlie has said that it's not going to be progressing a whole lot more into the new year, except for Mexico and Philippines. So we'll see what happens in the next year. So now let's look at the filing date chart, because this is still the chart that is used by the family based category for applying for their 485. So it's different for family based versus employment based. For almost the entire year, family based category uses the filing date chart, whereas for employment based category, in the second part of or starting January, of typically from January for new year, they start using the final action date chart for applying for I-485. Now, so now let's look at the filing date chart for family based category. So as you can see, it has not changed a whole lot for F1. In fact, it has not changed at all. So all chargeability, China, India, Mexico and Philippines, the dates remain the same for F1. Now let's look at F2A. As you can see, I'm not seeing any changes for F2A either. But let's look at F2B. There is still no change for F2B for all chargeability, China and India. But however, for Mexico, it has progressed from 8th of August 2000 to 1st of October 2000. So basically by 2 months, August to October. And for Philippines, it has not changed at all. For F3 category, nothing has changed for all chargeability, nothing has changed for China, nothing has changed for India. For Mexico, it has remained the same, and for Philippines, it has remained the same. And for F4 category, I don't see any change for all chargeability, I don't see any change for China. However, for India, it has progressed by a month, from 1st of December 2005 to 1st of January 2006, so which is good news. For Mexico, it has changed by about a month or 3 weeks, I should say, from 8th of May 99 to 1st of June 99. And for Philippines, it has changed. Actually, it has not changed at all. So there is a mixed bag over here. We have we can see F2A and F2B categories changed a little bit, but except for Mexico and Philippines, we haven't seen a lot of progression in dates, and that is supposed to stay as per Charlie throughout the start of the new year. So although we are seeing the consulates open, they still have a long backlog to fill. So if your dates are current at the consulate, try to get an appointment at your local consulate for your family-based migration case and see if you can slot in. It's not open everywhere because of the third wave and the variant of COVID, but if you can get an appointment, if your date is current, you might be lucky. So that's all from the family based category. Let's now go to the employment based category. Now here are the dates for final action dates for employment based preference cases. So we'll go through EB1 first, which hasn't changed at all. It has been current all throughout for all chargeability, China, all the LATAM nations, India, Mexico, Philippines and Vietnam. Everything is current for EB1. So what that means is they have enough visa numbers for all the applicants that are eligible for 485. So basically, if you are documentarily complete and if you are in the EB1 category, there is no wait time for you. There is a visa number available right away, and that's the reason they are showing the date as current. Now, however, it doesn't mean that once you apply, there is no wait time, because there is a processing time that still needs to be taken into account. So there still might be a wait of 1 or 2 or even more years, depending on the case backlog for that for your particular visa location. So now let's look at EB2. EB2, all chargeability remains current. For China, it has progressed from 1st of April 2018 to 1st of July 2018. So about 3 months progression for China. For El Salvador, Guatemala and Honduras, it remains current. For EB2 India, the dates have progressed by 3 months, from 1st of June 2011 to 1st of September 2011. So as we can see, they haven't progressed a lot. I was hoping that they catch up with December 2011 for EB2 India, but seems like they have gone halfway through. So what it means is, I think their USCIS is still processing all the visas very fast, as much as possible, but there is still going to be some backlog that is going to be remaining at the end of the year, so fiscal year basically. So there are still going to be some leftovers visa numbers that are going to be available, that are going to go waste. So for Mexico, Philippines and Vietnam, everything remains current. So I would say it's still a good news for India, because we have seen a lot more progression compared to last several years. 3 months progression is not bad. We have gotten used to 6 months and 7 months in the past couple of months, but considering the situation, I think 3 months progression for EB2 India is still commendable. So congratulations for anybody who has got your green cards in the last 2 months, and I'm hoping that with the faster processing that I'm hearing from USCIS, a lot many number of people are going to get their green cards in the month of September, before the end of this fiscal year. So EB3, all chargeability remains current. China has progressed, actually China has not progressed at all for EB3. It remains at January 8th of 2019. So that's kind of surprising. But for India, EB3, the dates have progressed from 1st of July 2013 to 1st of January 2014. So basically they have caught up with the date that was in the filing date chart at the beginning of the year. So USCIS kept its promise of meeting up with the final action filing date chart that was set a year back. So they have made that date. So basically they have moved by 6 months, and we are not going to see any more progression for this year at least. I'm going to talk about what might happen in October, but for this year, this is the date, this is the final dates that you're going to see for the end of September. Other workers category, again China has progressed by a month, from January 2010 to February 2010, and India has progressed also from July 2013 to January of 2014. So basically EB3 and other workers category are in lockstep. The other updates are EB4 for El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras. It has progressed by about two months, from January to March of 2019. And for Mexico, it has progressed by about a month, from February 2020 to March 2020. Rest of the categories, rest of the countries, all are current for EB4. For certain religious workers, exactly the same thing as EB4. For EB5, non-regional centers, only backlog country is China, and it has only progressed by about a week, from 15th of November 2015 to 22nd of November 2015. And as you can see, the fifth EB5 regional center category has been closed, so they are not accepting any applications in that category, so it remains unavailable. So that was not surprising. So I would say it's consistent for EB2 India and EB3 India. It is mostly consistent with what we have been expecting. However, I would have expected EB2 India to reach December of 2011 by September visa bulletin, but that obviously has not happened, and the reason might be because they are having a lot of cases to be processed, and thus we are seeing that it only reached halfway. We are thinking of 6 months progression for EB2 India, but it only progressed by 3 months, which is not bad either. But what that tells us is, although USCIS is doing all its best to kind of go through the applications that are current, it's still taking them a long enough time, because there is just the mere volume of applicants is very high. But there is one good news that I want to share, that USCIS just announced yesterday that they want to see your I-693 forms along with your 485 application. So if you are applying for 485, or if you have already applied for 485 but you haven't submitted your medical forms, which is I-693, you should do that right away without waiting for USCIS to submit you an RFE. If you do so, that saves a little bit of a time. In the past, it has been a hit or miss, because the typical validity for 693 form is 2 years from the date of your physician signature, but now they have extended that timeline or validity period for 693 from 2 years to 4 years. Now, I don't know if it's a good news or a bad news. It's a good news, because now you just have to submit it once and you don't have to worry about it for it to expire, which is a good news. But bad news in retrospect is, maybe USCIS is expecting that it might take several years for their 485 application to process, and they just want to make sure that there is they don't have to wait for another 693. So all in all, I think it's a good news. USCIS is doing all it can to process all the 485 applications and use up all those extra visa numbers for EB category before the end of September, so which is a very good news. So I'm hoping that all the everybody who has applied for 485 will get their green cards if their dates are current before the end of the year. We might still get surprised with what Charlie says, and we'll look at when the chat with Charlie will take place on August 19th at 1 p.m. So about a week from now, or next Thursday, I think. So that's when the interview with Charlie will take place. So Charlie will have a better understanding of how processing is going on in USCIS based on numbers that he gets from them. So we'll know about it, and I'll be sure to make a video on prediction for October visa bulletin. So stay tuned to my channel. If you haven't already subscribed, do subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to make a prediction for October visa bulletin based on this information. And if you like the content of this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel, and I'll see you in the next one.